Hello, people of the internet. My name is Combat Wombat. Before we hop into the video, just a quick thing I have to get out of the way. I understand a lot of you are upset with the new direction of my channel and the deletion of my older comedy commentary videos, where I poked fun at other videos for entertainment and jokes. Believe me, I'm not happy about it either. It's possible that I overreacted to this new creator-on-creator rule coming, but we just don't know right now. The rule isn't officially out just yet, but it already seems to be having an effect. Susan Watchkicky made it kind of seem like channels focused on criticism for either serious critique or comedy, like my channel was, won't be allowed anymore.
Our goal is to enable our content creators to create valuable content that's beneficial for society, not to be creating a content and getting their views by criticizing someone else. And then, like, where do you draw that line? Where do they cross the line that it's no longer just about ideas, but they're criticizing them as a person, criticizing or their channel is based upon that? I think we'll have a policy this year.
On the other hand, she also made it seem like the occasional criticism video that's attacking the idea and not the person will be okay. Honestly, it's unclear what is going to happen because YouTube loves to be vague, but I've been playing it safe. I haven't changed my style of video per se, just changed from criticizing YouTubers for comedy to criticizing gaming-related things for comedy. Either way, if it turns out I'm wrong about the creator-on-creator harassment rules coming, I'll come back to doing videos just like this one as my main style of content. For now, we'll just do it on occasion. Anyways, enough of that. A YouTuber named Kino made a response video to Shoe on Head's video about maps or minor attracted persons. His video was titled, "Shoe on Head is Too Mean to Pedophiles." The video got taken down faster than my IQ drops when I'm playing Roblox, but I made sure to download it. So let's see what he had to say.
A map is a minor attracted person. Basically, it is a cute little nickname pedophiles are giving themselves in order to get good PR.
I mean, that might be one of the reasons they implement the term map. And, you know, the pedophile community should have better PR because they deserve to be defended.
Whoa, hold up! I'm gonna stop you right there, Buckaroo. Everything you just said there is level 300 bullshit. First of all, please don't call pedophiles a community. I'd rather not think of these scumbags meeting up at the water cooler on Monday afternoon chatting up about how much they like children. Alright? No thank you. It's not a community, okay? They're not Dota players. They are mentally ill, and no, they should not be defended. Why would you even say that?
I think that another reason why pedophiles choose to refer to themselves as MAP, though, is because the term pedophile, as you know, people treat that term with a lot of hostility in our modern culture, so...
Well, you don't say. They call themselves MAPs to try and rebrand themselves. As if changing the term from pedo to minor attracted person makes people think, oh, in that case, that's all right. No. You're still a sicko, name change or not.
I think in terms of like making them feel more comfortable about identifying themselves, they use the term MAP, and I think that's completely reasonable.
What, are pedophiles now a part of the LGBTQ+YZX coordinates pie chart? They identify as pedos by calling themselves MAPs? No, no, and more no. This isn't a sexuality like being gay or bisexual. It's a disgusting mental illness.
I don't give him the same amount of shit as baby diddlers because he's not trying to normalize diddling babies.
Admittedly, there is a huge portion of the pedophile community that tries to defend sexual acts with babies. I do not want to associate with them. I think that defending sexual acts with babies is obviously extremely bad because babies are cognitively incapable of consenting to sexual acts.
Keep what he just said in mind. It'll be important later.
I feel that only at around the age of 4 are children perhaps able to consent to sexual acts.
It's later. What the fuck? Where is the bleach? I need it. In my ear. Right now. You just said that you don't think babies are cognitively able to consent to sexual acts, which, no shit. A 4-year-old? Is a toddler, dude. They're watching Rugrats and eating their boogers at that age. What is wrong with you?
Even from the ages of 4 to 7, I think that is only a really small minority, and only perhaps gifted children are able to consent.
Gifted children? 4 to 7? You do realize that kids from the age of 4 to 7 don't even know what sex is? What you're saying right now is why people hate pedophiles. Right here. This is why. It's repulsive. You are making me sick to my stomach right now.
For ages 8 to 12, though, I would hazard that a majority of cases would be able to consent to sexual acts.
No, they cannot. Children cannot consent. Period. For the same reasons you listed earlier. They do not understand what sex is, they are not sexually developed or mature, and what you are saying is fucking disgusting. Stop.
And for children ages 12 and above, it is extremely clear that they are perfectly able to consent to sexual acts. They have enough cognitive ability, they have the ability to verbally communicate with an adult sufficiently.
You seem to be under the extremely silly notion that if a child does consent, whether they know what they are consenting to or not, that it's okay to have sexual relations with them. Are you under that impression? Because if so, the FBI would like a word. The reason the legal age in some states is 16 and not 18 is because around that age, people have matured sexually and are understanding of it. Before that, no. I still think that it's extremely odd, and I think the legal age should always be 18 because that's far closer to being an adult, but that's how it is.
Yet cultures still aren't willing to reduce or abolish the age of consent for sex, and that's really bad.
No. It's not.
Because there are many harmless consensual relationships between children and adults.
There is no such thing as a harmless romantic relationship between a child and an adult. From what you mentioned earlier, you think 4-year-olds can consent. There is nothing harmless about that. Before the age of 10, you haven't even hit puberty yet. They're still learning the color blue. You're wrong. Period.
Perfectly harmless. Everything is innocent. And if you penalize acts on the basis of just age alone, you harm both the child and the adult.
You trying to have a sexual relationship with a child is harming the child. Nothing about imprisoning a pedophile is harming the child. In fact, it's quite the opposite. It's helping the child get away from the sicko that is taking advantage of them and their lack of knowledge about the world.
Because the adult is completely innocent, he didn't cause any harm.
You are so unbelievably wrong that it is painful to listen to.
And the child, well, from the trauma of having their adult lover taken away from him.
Why am I still on this planet? Can aliens just get here and blow us up already?
It's an extreme emotional blow for the child, which is very ironic because anti-pedophiles try to claim that they are defending child abuse.
Oh, I think I spotted a Freudian slip.
Defending child abuse?
It's you that is defending child abuse. Because in reality, it is child abuse. It is manipulating a child who is incapable of consent and is not mature enough to understand what is going on. And obviously, I shouldn't have to say this, it is abuse to have sexual interactions with a child. You need help.
When the act of taking away somebody's adult lover that is completely innocent.
They aren't innocent at all. Also, stop saying adult lover, please.
That is a huge mental blow that I would classify as child abuse, so...
So, separating a child from an adult who is manipulating them into sexual acts they aren't capable of or willing to participate in cognitively is abuse. But the adult manipulating the child is not abusing them. Bravo. Really intelligent argument you got there. Basically, what you're advocating is grooming. It's grooming. You are advocating grooming children.
Oh, I wonder why there's such a stigma against grown-ass adults fucking pre-pubescent children. You know who else gets a bad stigma? Murderers.
Most of the pedophile community, and if you've read up on the most prominent pedophile organizations throughout history, you would know that they vehemently condemn any sort of child abuse. What they are defending is consensual, harmless sexual acts between adults and children.
Sexual acts with a child is abuse, period. Moving on.
Therefore, the comparison to murderers and rapists is extremely flawed.
Yeah, you're right. Rapists who have non-consensual sex with an adult who manipulate them with physical force are completely different from pedophiles who manipulate children, both mentally or physically, into sexual acts. Again, your argument is dumb. Really dumb. Criminally dumb.
No, they are snakes trying to co-opt their movement, preying on people's empathy and tolerance. It's because they're trying to sneak into the gay rights movement so their sexuality is accepted. They're latching on a movement that is currently, finally, seeing acceptance, which makes them snakes.
When pedophiles try to appeal to the gay community, I think that it's extremely reasonable. Because for one, I think the LGBT community and the pedophile community are in a similar vein to the extent that both groups were born with a sexual attraction that they could not control.
The difference is that members of the LGBT are attracted to the same gender, pedos are attracted to young children. The only reason people like you compare the two groups is because people in the LGBT are accepted by society, and like Shuon Head said, you are snakes. You want to slither your way into being accepted by society by comparing yourself to LGBT. Not going to happen. You aren't just attracted to a gender that is not typical for you to be attracted to. That's fine. It's not a negative thing. It's two consenting adults of the same gender being attracted to one another. You're attracted to young children who are not able to consent. It is a mental illness, not a sexuality. It's not a preference. It's a sick attraction that is abnormal. It's disgusting. It's vile. It has no place in society. Bitch.
So both gays and pedophiles have had to face that similar kind of discrimination where they should be able to freely explore their sexuality because it doesn't harm anyone.
Gay people are having consensual relationships with an adult who is not dependent on another adult for care and is sexually mature. Pedophiles prey on children. These are other people's children who they are protecting from people like pedophiles because they cannot protect themselves. They are incapable of fending for themselves. They cannot consent. What you are trying to justify is unjustifiable, which is why you will always be criticized for it, and that's why your video is taken down.
You can be a gay pedophile or a straight pedophile, and then go die.
Yeah, so this is the kind of hostile language that we're really against. And look, if let's say you disagree with any of my views on pedophilia, that's fine. But could we at least come to a compromise where you do not treat this group as hostile as people have typically been right now?
No. Fuck pedophiles. They're disgusting. Lock them all up and throw away the key.
Sending death threats, telling them that they should go hang themselves, spamming unoriginal Chris Hansen memes.
While I don't agree with telling people to kill themselves or sending death threats, there is a very good reason why people are so hostile with them. It's because of the reasons I've already listed. It's disgusting. It's taking advantage of someone who doesn't know any better. And it's very much illegal.
Pedophile is not equal to child abuser. One is sexually attracted to children, one ravages children.
He's laughing at that sentence. Creepy.
Hold on, why didn't you address his point?
She probably didn't address it because his point was shit sauce. It is abuse to manipulate a child into sexual acts, period. Simply because the child is being manipulated or forced. This is supposed to be common sense, my dude. Shuon Head shouldn't even have to debate the point he made. It was fucking stupid. Just like your entire video is.
A lot of you are minors, like, a lot. If you guys see anybody with the terms map, no map, AOA, a clown emoji, or a circus tent emoji, stay far away from them. These are the things they use to identify themselves. If they contact you at all, block them.
As we've established, most pedophiles do not want to harm minors. In fact, they would want probably an extremely beneficial and fruitful relationship with a child.
Yeah. Take Shuon Head's advice, avoid these people like the plague. Block them. Beneficial and fruitful relationship with a child is the creepiest thing I've ever heard. Seriously.
So blocking them on the basis of their sexual attraction is just extremely rude and discriminatory.
Also, Kino, stop pulling the discrimination card. Pedos are sick, mentally ill people. They are not a race or a sexuality.
The general sense I'm getting here from June is that she does not want to engage in discussions on the topic with such people, and I don't think that's good.
Dude, you blocked the comments and ratings on your video. You clearly don't care to have any discussion. Also, please, Kino, or anybody else who identifies as a map, tweet at me at ClickTaser on Twitter. Let's get into a live debate on this topic. I'd love to have you on the Combat Womcast or whatever I'd call the live stream. So yeah, tweet at me. I'll wait.
I think all of us would agree that we want to try to not harm as many innocent people as we can, and bring help to as much people as we're able to.
Okay, don't be a pedo. You won't cause any harm then. And check yourself into a program or seek mental help. That will be getting help to people, mainly yourself. Anyways, that's pretty much his entire video. I apologize if I seem to repeat my points over and over. He pretty much did the same, just kept saying children could consent and all I can do is argue why they can't, really. Thank you for watching and have a good one. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you guys understand why I've had to make a shift in content, but I will be doing the occasional commentary like this. A huge thank you to all of my channel members and Patreon sponsors. You guys are absolutely amazing. Thank you so much.